When Ed Kip Malone was just 12 years old, he performed a heroic act by rescuing two young girls from a house fire. Over the years, he often wondered what became of them. Then one day, 65 years later, a surprise visitor knocked on his door, changing his life forever. In November 2016, Malone moved into a new house in Conception Bay South, Newfoundland and Labrador. Although he had grown up in St. John's, he had spent time working in Ontario. Upon retiring, he decided to return to his hometown. It was there that he met his next-door neighbor, who would play a pivotal role in this heartwarming story. The date was December 20, 1951, and young Malone, age 12, had been sent by his mother to buy some butter. As he walked along Central Street, he noticed a house engulfed in flames. Panic filled the air, and desperate cries for help echoed from the third floor. A woman on the third floor was screaming for someone to save the children trapped inside the burning building. Without hesitation, young Malone sprang into action. He rushed inside, propelled by a sense of urgency and the instinct to help. Looking back during an interview with CBC News, St. John's morning show, he recalled, "I knew there was an emergency, so I just ran over to that house." Inside, he quickly ascended the stairs and encountered a little girl. She was hesitant to leave with him because she didn't know the whereabouts of her sister. Malone, too, was unsure of her sister's location. He recounted the chaotic scene, saying, "She had no idea, and no more did I. The house by now was full of smoke, but I knew there was a little girl somewhere." Driven by determination and guided by a voice from above, Malone continued his search and eventually found the hidden child. He described the moment, saying, "I think it was the man upstairs that said to me, 'Sweep your hand under the bed.' And I did, and I grabbed the little girl. So now I had two, so I went. And I wanted to get out of that house too because it was full of smoke and burning." The two girls, aged 5 and 3 at the time, owed their lives to Malone's courageous act. Unfortunately, not everyone in the house was as fortunate. Their grandmother tragically perished in the fire, and the home was left severely damaged. The family, consisting of 2 parents and 8 children, all managed to escape unharmed. However, their beloved home was rendered uninhabitable due to the extensive damage caused by the flames. As Malone grew older, he often pondered the fate of the two girls he had saved that day. While the fire had made headlines, Malone, affectionately known as Kip due to his fondness for kippers, explained that he had been too young at the time to fully understand or inquire about the aftermath. He stated, "I was only 12 at the time, and I didn't know anything about it and didn't know anybody to ask, so I just let it go." Nevertheless, he never forgot what had transpired that fateful day and always wondered about the two children he had rescued. For 65 years, he searched for answers without success. Then, a serendipitous encounter unfolded. After moving into their new house, Malone and his wife were visited by their next-door neighbor, who came over to introduce herself. As they began to converse, they realized that they had both grown up in the same area. The woman who knocked on his door was Margaret Fowler, and she disclosed to him that her family had resided on Central Street. This prompted Malone to share the remarkable story of how he had rescued 2 young sisters from a deadly fire on that very street many years ago. His tale left her utterly stunned. Recalling the moment, Malone said, "She just looked at me and nearly fainted. She said, 'I'm the little girl.'" Fowler revealed that she had very few memories of the fire and hadn't recognized Malone. Nevertheless, she was rendered speechless by his revelation. "I couldn't get over it when Kip told us that," she remarked on St. John's morning show. "It's a miracle as far as I'm concerned. I think it was meant to be." Fowler promptly introduced Malone to her sister, Barbara Earle, the other little girl he had saved on that fateful day in 1951. Over the years, both Malone and the sisters had lost their parents, and they couldn't help but feel that their chance reunion was a twist of fate. "It's not just a coincidence," Earle affirmed, a sentiment echoed by Malone and Fowler. Fowler added, "I don't know, but it was something that happened up in heaven that our parents got us together." Earle disclosed that she had been unaware of a stranger saving her life until she met Malone. As young children at the time, they hadn't asked their parents for details about the fire due to its sensitive nature. However, they were now grateful to know the truth. Fowler and Earle wholeheartedly acknowledged that their life journeys wouldn't have been possible without Malone's heroic act. Meeting him has given them a profound sense of gratitude and affection. Fowler became emotional as she expressed, "We really are grateful, and God love him. I love him." Earle concurred, saying, "I feel so blessed. If it wasn't for Kip, I wouldn't be here today and have the beautiful, wonderful life and family that I have." She also emphasized that now that they have reunited, they won't let anything separate them again. How do you thank him, only to say thank you? Earl mused. I mean, there will always be this connection with us. And that I love you, I don't know what else to say. Despite 65 years of not knowing each other, it appears that this trio is determined to make up for lost time. Malone, equally thrilled and deeply moved, is overjoyed that he finally had the opportunity to meet the children he had wondered about for so long. He shared his happiness, saying, I'm going to have to digest it for a while, because for a lot of years, I've wondered what became of the two little girls, and I've only just found out, two beautiful women with families, so I'm very happy for it.